Oke, jadi ini cerita dari Jawa Timur, yaitu Cinde Laras.
Cinde Laras.
Long time ago, live a man named Raden Putra. Actually, he's the king of Jenggala lah. He is the king of a very great kingdom. And he had an enjoyment of cockfighting lah ya, colliding rooster ya. He enjoyed that lah that time. And he also believed that his rooster is like the greatest rooster in the kingdom. So all rooster in the kingdom lose lah to Raden Putra's rooster. Okay. Raden Putra had a wife and a concubine. I don't know lah, this Raden Putra, I don't know whether he's handsome or not. But then how come he got a wife and a concubine, I don't know. And the queen, the wife, is very beautiful, kind, generous, also patient lah. But then this concubine is everything that the queen wasn't. Aiya, she was very mean eh, selfish, greedy, jealous also. Aiya, this concubine very bad eh. But then one time, the concubine felt jealous of the queen because she thought that Raden Putra treated the queen better than her, and she heard that the queen was pregnant. So she decided to make a bad plan lah, to dispose the queen of, just kick her out lah. On the day the concubine ran, she pretended to be sick. She just pretended to be sick or suffer from illness. Then she called her royal physician. Then the royal physician said, "Aiya, your majesty, the concubine has been poisoned lah by the queen." Then Raden Putra was shocked. "Is it true?" said, I asked Raden Putra, "Your majesty, I will never do that to your concubine lah. I'm a very kind person lah. Aiya, you think I will do that to your concubine? No lah, obviously not, it's not me eh." But then Raden Putra didn't believe his own wife, so he decided to kick the queen lah. "Aiya, you go out lah, I hate you, I don't trust you anymore," said Raden Putra. Wow, the queen was very sad eh. The queen was very sad. So she disposed to the forest, right? Then when actually Raden Putra asked the duke to kill her in the forest. But then the duke knew lah, because the queen was a very kind person, right? So the duke asked the queen, "Is it true that you put the poison inside the concubine's meal?" asked the duke. "Obviously not lah, aiya! I'm the first lady of this kingdom lah. Why you think I need to put something to somebody's meal? Hey, you think I'm stupid lah? No lah!" But then, so the duke believed lah. The duke believed the queen. So he made a small hut. You know, hut, small hut by wood. And on his way to the palace, he killed a deer to make sure that the king would believe lah that he already killed the queen. Okay, 9 months later, the queen finally gave birth. Yeah, because she was pregnant that time, right? Okay, she named her baby boy Cinde Laras. Yeah, she was very happy lah because she had friend in the forest, right? So she's not alone. And time flies. Cinde Laras grew into a very kind-hearted boy. He was very handsome, generous, and always helped his mother on chores. But then one day, when he helped his mother on collecting some firewood, he saw an eagle, drop an egg. Whoa, big egg, leh. So he ran back home. He ran back home and tells his mother, "Mother, I found something new, eh. Ma, look at this," said Cinde Laras. Soon after that, the egg had finally hatched. It became a very strong rooster. But then, this one is not a very ordinary rooster. The rooster could sing eh! Can you believe? Rooster could sing! Every morning, Cinde Laras woke up early to hear the rooster sing. "Cuckoo, cuckoo-roo-yoo, my master is Cinde Laras. He lives in the woods, he is the son of Raden Putra." Every morning, Cinde Laras woke up early, right, to hear the rooster sing. he tried to understand all word by word of the song until he finally understood it. But there was something that he couldn't understand. So he asked his mother, "Mother, who is Radin Putra? The rooster always called his name, eh?" He's my husband, eh? Your father, the king of Jangala. Ayo, really? Hey, is that me? I'm the prince, eh? And you're the queen? I'm a prince? I cannot believe myself, eh? Really? Yes, my son, you're actually the prince of this kingdom. So the day after that time, he went to the palace to see the king. And on his way to the palace, he stopped to one village to rest up. But then on that small village, he saw some men doing cockfighting. One man came to Cinde Laras because he was holding his rooster. "Hey you bring your rooster, right? Come, let's go to cockfighting." Cinde Laras never been to cockfighting before, but he tried it anyway lah. After all of the fight, Cinde Laras was not always won, eh? He cannot even believe his own rooster. All of the rooster in the village lose to Cinde Laras' rooster. They are very not so good lah. Cinde Laras' rooster very nice one, eh? Like golden rooster. The news about Cinde Laras' rooster quickly spread out to the community. Even the king heard all about it. The king was very furious, so he invited Cinde Laras to the kingdom, to the palace. "What is your name, boy?" asked Radin Putra. "I am Cinde Laras, your majesty," answered Cinde Laras. He's very happy because he met his own father, the king of Jangala. As Radin Putra believed, he has the strongest sister in the kingdom, he challenged Cinde Laras. "Hey, your little boy, if your rooster win, you will get half my wealth. But if you lose, you will be killed," said the king. Well, Cinde Laras accepted the challenge. The palace was the competition was held in front of the palace yard. The two cock were fighting so bravely. But then after a few minutes, Cinde Laras rooster won, eh. Radin Putra was so shocked. "Hiya! That rooster is not ordinary rooster, and so does the boy. Who is he exactly?" But then, right after the competition, Cinde Laras rooster quickly sing to the song. "Cuckoo, cuckoo, my master is Cinde Laras. He lives in the woods. He is the son of Radin Putra." What? "Oh, you're my son, eh? How come I have a son like you, I don't have a son, eh? My concubine is not pregnant, what? I don't make her pregnant,
I don't make
her pregnant. Hey, really? I'm your son, eh? Don't you believe the rooster sing just now, what? Cannot, I sleep with other girls, but then I don't make kids. You don't believe, my mother lived in the forest, you know? You kick her out, and you still don't believe I'm your son? Oh yeah, I kicked the queen out of the palace, eh? So she's pregnant, Obviously, you think I came out from where? You're my son, okay, I'm sorry, So Radin Putra apologized, to her son, right? And to his son. But then, to make him believe, he called the concubine. "Is that true? You put your poison inside your meal by yourself?" "Hey, you think I'm stupid, I will never put my poison inside my meal by myself, eh? How can I poison my own body, But then the queen is more prettier than you, I know her. But then, I don't trust it. You. Now, please call back the queen here to the palace and I kick you out." So, at the end, Radin Putra kicked the concubine. And right after that time, he picked up the queen at the forest. And finally, Cinde Laras, Raden Putra, the Queen, and the Rooster, obviously Rooster, lived happily together. But then, after Raden Putra died, Cinde Laras replaced the position of his father as a king. He ruled his country justly and wisely. Yeah.
Teman-teman semua, jadi cucuku ini dulu bulan lalu kalau nggak salah bertanding di Malaysia untuk pelajar-pelajar Indonesia di Singapura Malaysia bertanding, tetapi membawakannya dalam pure good English. Jadi bukan seperti sekarang. Begitu bagusnya, ada juri-jurinya orang-orang Barat semua di sana, dan cucuku ini dapat juara pertama dengan dapat medali emas. Nah, untuk ulang tahun Nenda, saya minta hadiah dari Dayita, namanya Dayita. The cute, pretty Dayita. Mau kasih hadiah buat Nenda. Nenda, saya bawakan cerita yang Cinde Laras itu ya, yang saya dulu menang. Boleh? Tapi tante-tantenya, omnya semuanya pada bilang,